Good morning, Rice Lane. It is really good to see you again, or whenever it is you're listening to this, our assembly. The mission of Jesus continues. Oh, we've had such a journey, haven't we? Following on from, of course, the Christmas story, then through to Easter. And after Easter, we've heard how Jesus has appeared to his disciples, to people at the tomb, in an upper room, and even last week on a beach, having a barbecue together. Well, what we're going to do today, we're just going to go back to the evening before Jesus was crucified, because Jesus had some very special words that he wanted to speak to his disciples, to tell them about, so that they would be prepared for what was going to happen next after Jesus died and rose again. And one day Jesus was going to ascend back into heaven. And we'll talk about that next week. And so the words that Jesus had to say, these are part of the words that he was talking with them in the upper room when they were having a Passover meal before he was arrested. So before we go any further, here's a word search with some important words that will come up in our narrative today, in our story today. So see if you can pick up the words in the word search. You might have to pause it. Then we'll come back, carry on with the story. Then I've got a song for you. Now you'd be glad to know that I'm not singing, but it's a song that's quite a catchy tune. And you'll hear the song repeated a couple of times, so maybe you can just pick it up really, really quickly and follow some of the words before we close. Word search, back to me. See you in a moment. So then, you're able to pick up some of those words, okay? Hope you can, because here's where we're going. The disciples had so many questions to ask of Jesus. What was really happening? We know that they didn't fully understand what was going on. And Jesus was so kind and so gentle as he spoke with them, and he tried to help them understand. And the understanding only fully came after Jesus rose from the dead, and a special event happened. We'll talk about that, as we said, next week. So here we go. Jesus says this to the boys. He says, listen, don't let your hearts be troubled. If you trust in God, if you believe in God, then believe also in me. And this is the command that he gave them then. He said, listen, lots of things are going to happen, but this is how I want you to live. And this is how I want you to act. He says, I want you to love one another. I want you to show people that you belong to me, that you're a follower of Jesus, in the way that you live and love one another. A really important commandment that Jesus gave them to follow. And that's true for all who say they follow Jesus. It must be shown in how they love each other. And of course, the disciples were working all this through, as we still do today, and think, what does that mean for us today? But let's just hear some of the other things. Don't let your hearts be troubled. Hey, hang on to God. Trust in God in all of this. But he said another couple of things. He said, I will not leave you. I will not leave you on your own. Actually, I will come to you. You will not be like orphans, as though somebody's lost their parents. No, I will be with you. And that must have been a strange thing for the disciples to hear, because they knew that Jesus, or well, the next day Jesus died, then he rose again 3 days later, and eventually Jesus was going to leave this earth and ascend into heaven. So I wonder what he really meant when he says, I will never leave you, I will always be with you. And the disciples were thinking that through, and we'll explore that over the coming weeks. And of course, Jesus said some other lovely words to him, lots of words. And these are another phrase that he used, and word set of words he used. Peace I give you. I'll leave you my peace. And I want you to know this shalom in your hearts. It's a peace that doesn't mean it's quiet outside. We've already talked about that some weeks back. It's not a peace that means there's an absence of conflict or there are not difficult issues that you will have to deal with, but it's a peace that you have in your heart. And so when Jesus was talking about these things, he was saying, hey, listen, don't be troubled in your heart. Keep trusting in God. We will never leave you on your own. And actually, we will give you our peace. I'll give you a peace that the world doesn't understand, and a peace that reigns in your heart. And that peace is a peace that means with God, the relationship is right. So God up here, us down here, and the relationship with God is joined and in harmony together. And they must have been great words for the disciples to think about and really grasp and understand after Jesus rose from the dead and as he showed himself to be alive and after he ascended into heaven. So let's listen to this song. It's taken from a letter that John wrote. Remember who John was? John was one of the disciples who ran to the tomb with Peter. And John went into the tomb and saw the grave clothes empty. And he stood by the tomb there and knew that Jesus had risen from the dead at that moment. He was John who saw Jesus in the upper room. He was a John who was fishing on the boat with Peter and had breakfast on the beach. And John writes these words to a church some years later. And he says, hey, love one another. Love like Jesus loved. Don't forget, these are the words that Jesus commanded us. So here's the song. And then following the song, I'll just come back and say a prayer. And we'll say bye for today.
Not
Well, I hope you enjoyed that song. It's good, isn't it? The tune's quite catchy. Hope you picked up some of the words. I hope you were able to maybe just clap and sing along a little bit as you were able to join in. Let me pray for us as we finish today. Dear Lord Jesus, we thank you for today. And again, we thank you for the children and staff of Rice Lane School. And we thank you for all the families that are represented. We continue to ask and pray that you'll keep them safe, that you'll help them through difficult days and troubled days, and that they may have time to think about some of the things that they hear in our assemblies, and that they might give thought to what it might mean to have the peace of God in their hearts, and how you long for them to know of your love and what you have done for them. So keep them and us safe, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen.